All right, guys, it's right there. Turn your right, Andrew.
All right, I'm gonna pull in, guys. You guys wait in the car. I'm gonna scout the garage out first, man. If everything's cool, I'm gonna give you a thumbs up. You guys come in.
Hey, where's he at?
You know this place, right?
Yes.
Are you sure?
It's safe.
Nice, there it is.
Yes!
Yes! Nice, like it.
I told you.
This is exactly what our customer would love to have.
This Combi looks great from a distance, but what looks good from 5 feet away may not be perfect in close inspection. Combis are very prone to rust. You have to really inspect it close to make sure that it's in good quality, it has been well restored, and it's worth it for our customers.
These doors are clean. Yeah. There's literally no rust at all or any repair that I can tell.
Can I do that?
What? What is this?
The key.
This is the key?
Yeah.
Oh, man, this is how they had it back in the 60s, huh?
Oh, cool.
When was it last rebuilt?
Oh, one atrás.
A year ago. A year.
So a year at the same time they restore the car, they restore the whole mechanical.
A whole the mechanical.
Yeah, it looks really good. Oil looks good. Can we hear it run while we're back here?
Okay.
Yes.
When you're inspecting a vehicle, it's imperative that you listen to the engine. You want to hear it where you can actually tell that there's no knocks, all the valves are adjusted correctly, and make sure that we're not going to have to rebuild that engine when we get it back home.
Okay?
Okay. Looks like it was truly rebuilt about a year ago. So the exterior is really good. The motor is great. What about the interior?
Was it done too?
Look at these.
You don't find them like this. This guy went through the whole thing with a fine-tooth comb.
This is my favorite part, too.
The spare tire behind the front seat, that's pretty
cool. That's really cool.
One of the great things about the Combi is the incredible use of space. It's so efficient. I mean, there was no trunk space, so they put the spare tire right behind the front seat. It's awesome.
So, bottom line, what's the price?
Let's talk about the price. Quanto você está pedindo por ela?
65 mil reais.
65 mil reales.
65, sim. Guys.
65,000?
It's worth.
Oh, come on.
Não custam tanto.
Não, é 65 mil mesmo. Vale isso. Você não vai achar outro
igual. It's worth it.
Well.
It's a good car.
Can you lower 50. The price? If we can buy this Combi for around 30 grand, we're gonna be able to sell it for about twice the price to our customer back in Austin. But we gotta keep the cost way down because shipping it back to the States isn't cheap.
65 e uma cerveja.
That's too much. How about we offer you 50 y dos cervezas?
62 y tres
62 and three beers.
He's not really working with us.
No, no. You gotta lower it down a little bit.
If we can't do a deal, we can just go look at another one.
Ele falou que se ele não fizer o negócio, ele vai olhar para outro carro. Vamos lá, vamos fechar esse negócio.
Oh, mas eu vou fazer 60. 60.
Okay.
What does that come out to be?
Around 2.2.
About 27K?
27.
It's a nice rig.
We got a deal.
Okay.
Okay.
The buyer for this car is gonna be more than happy. They're gonna be ecstatic when they see this car. Hey, Andrew, do you have the money? It was absolutely worth taking the risk going through this neighborhood to get to this gem.
You got the title for the document?
Okay.
Documento?
It is.
Okay.
Okay, we've got 60,000, 20,000 each.
How about the beers?
We need to go to the bar, to the beer.
Let's go.
Okay.
Awesome. Hey, thank you. Obrigado, eh?
Thank you.
Obrigado.
Obrigada, Carl.
I'm stoked. We have covered our cost to be here in Brazil. Now we can focus into expanding our market and finding better cars.
We're ready to roll.
Good job. I'm proud of you guys. But listen, man, we're going to be driving off. Leave room in front of you. Don't get boxed in. I'm going to be following you guys. Don't drive too fast. Don't lose me.
Okay, so that sounds good. Let's hear this, baby.
Andrew has arranged to take the Combi to a secure location, 30 kilometers north in the neighborhood of Via Mariana. But first, they must get out of the slums of Extremo Sul. 6 kilometers into their journey.
What the hell? Oh, my God, there's a car in between us now. I told them not to do that. This isn't good. I'm separated from them. What the hell is this guy doing? He's pursuing aggressively. This isn't right.
What?
It's our car.
Okay. How do we even know if she's in on it?
I've seen scams like this before. This is a bait and switch.
You gotta get out of here.
We can exchange the money.
No. Wait, he wants to give us the money back.
No, we're not going to the garage.
Look, if he wants to meet us at the hotel, that's fine. Okay. We'll talk there. Nowhere else. We're getting out of here.
Oh, God.
Move the car! This makes no sense. We just bought this car. We have the title work. How could Larissa get us into a situation like this?
I don't know how it happened.
I don't trust Larissa. We don't know her for sure. Is this woman just trying to set up the guys that I'm here to protect? I don't know.
Back at the hotel, the guys try to settle the dispute.
We're absolutely not giving this combi back. We paid for it. We got the paperwork. It's done. It's a done
Let's
deal.
Make it
it's
out.
Their
You're
problem.
Right.
Que passou?
Eu pensei que eu tivesse autorização para vender. Entendeu? Ele me deu autorização. Assim, eu tenho um problema com ele que eu vou resolver com ele.
He thought he had an authorization to sell it. It was a mistake.
Okay, that's their problem, and that's not our problem.
No.
Giving the money back.
We're not taking it. No.
Chimo,
it's two problemas.
Hey, we bought
we
the car.
We're going to keep it. We did the deal with him.
Eu achei que eu tinha autorização de vender o carro.
Okay, sorry. Você não devia ter feito isso comigo, gente. Eu também fui pega de surpresa, porque eu conhecia um dos dois. Eu não sabia que tinham dois donos, então eu fiquei muito brava com a gente.
Eu não vou estar explicado.
Ok. Então, se você não quer fazer negócio assim, ok. Eu estou desculpado.
Given the car back, it's not the best business scenario, but this is our first time in Brazil, and we don't want to kill a reputation right off the bat. The fact is that this seller could have told other people that we're not doing proper business, and it would have hurt us for future deals.